brothers and sisters, very strange subject that we have come across this evening, which existed since the dawn of man on this earth, and a subject about which man disputes till today. And this proves that the subject is inevitable, and it proves that there is a necessity of the subject for man to develop. There are strange and fantastic notions about astrology from the beginning till today. Always a sense of mystery surrounds the idea of astrology, and it is like an utopia and a fairy tale in the mind of many. And we will try to know and understand what idea we have to form about astrology in order to make use of such a subject in a proper manner. It is used for prediction by some, and by some people it is used to know the proper diagnosis of the diseases, and some people make a self-analysis of themselves by studying their own horoscope, know their own potentialities, their own strong points and weak points, and understand what they have to do and what they should not do, when to do and when not to do. This is one of the real uses of astrology. The ancient Indian seers compared it with a lamp in the room. If you illumine the lamp in the room, then you will be able to see what is there in the room, and then you will walk in the room without stumbling and faltering. But the light in the room, it never adds anything to the already existing articles in the room. Similarly, the knowledge of astrology works as a light in your own life. It never adds anything to your life, nor does it take away anything from your life. But it decides what is there in you and what for you are born and what is your fitness in this world. In that way, it is very valuable. If we follow psychology and try to understand ourselves, it is not only useless, but it is also dangerous. Because psychology as it exists in the 20th century is a science of analysis of problems without solutions. A psychologist can explain you why you are not sleeping, but he has no solution to offer to you. And he can tell you why you are forgetful, why you are nervous, why you are somatic, psychosomatic, but he has no solution to offer to you. So the present psychology of the universities of the world is a science of wonderful analysis of problems without offering any solutions at all. So instead of following such fantastic subjects as psychology, if we try to understand what astrology is in its true sense, we can know the right values of our life. We can know where we are strong and where we are weak, and what we are expected to do and what not to do. So it is a science of analysis with solutions. But as long as we think that it is a science of prediction, it fools us. It is not intended for prediction, mainly. And if A newly married couple is goes and asks the astrologer when they will get a child.
Lorsqu'ils auront un enfant.
It is useless. Because it is not written in horoscope that every couple gets a child on such and such a date. But there is a time for everyone to get anything. But these are not the questions that are to be posed to use astrology in a proper way. A husband among a new couple went to an astrologer and said, "Sir, my wife is pregnant. I want to know if I get a male child or a female child." Then the astrologer smiled and asked, "How many months of pregnancy your wife is having?" He said, "Now 8 months." The best way of knowing whether you get a male child or female child, I'll tell you, he said. Then the husband asked, "Tell me, sir." Then the astrologer said, "The best way is to wait for 2 more months. Because you can know it surely." So, such things are not intended to be the real use of astrology. In India, there is a strange story about a king who wanted a reading. A king was not having children for a very long time. And finally, it was understood that his wife was carrying. And there was an astrologer in his court, royal astrologer. That astrologer was a fool, he did not know anything at all. But he was there in his court for many years. Then the king sent messengers to the astrologer asking if it would be a son or a daughter. Then the astrologer was in great trouble. Then he said, "There is a great curse to this king, malediction. If anything can be known, the child will be an abortion. So let us wait. But at the same time, I should prove the validity of astrology. I will write down the answer on a paper and keep it sealed in a cover. And after the child is born, the king can take the cover, tear it off and verify. Then he can know the validity of the signs." Then the king said, "Yes, sir." Then the king got a male child. He sent word to the astrologer. The messengers came and said, "The king has a son." Then the astrologer said, "There is the cover sealed. You take it to the royal court. Tear it in the front of all the officers and the king. And then read it out. You will know the correctness of astrology." They found it was correct. But the fact is, the astrologer acted as a magician. He has prepared 2 different covers, and in one he has written a son, in the other he has written a daughter. And the one he has put somewhere and the other he has put in some other direction. So it was only a magician and necromancy and no astrologer at all. But astrology's purpose is different. The truth of astrology lies in what we call the law of correspondences. What is the law of correspondences? As above, so is below is the law. The seed of a banyan tree bears all the parts of the banyan tree, as I told you a few hours ago. The relationship between the banyan tree and the seed is the same as the relationship between the whole universe and yourself. Your solar system is like a full-fledged tree developed, and you are one among the millions and millions of the seeds of the solar system. You may think that you are very insignificant, but when you know the potentiality of the banyan seed, how can you think the banyan seed as a useless thing? Similarly, by knowing the right type of astrology, you can never think that you are insignificant. It makes you find your position, and it gives you how the trend of things go. It tells you how the world around you is. It tells you how the world within yourself is. And it informs you also about the gateways between the two worlds. For example, if you see the sun and the moon and their movements, you will understand the center of illumination and also the surface of reflection. The sun is the center of illumination. The moon is the surface of reflection. And you will see from this earth globe. And you will understand how the correspondences go. Can I use this paper to show something to you? As you probably understand, the sun, the moon, and the earth, you will understand what you say, I am in you. The center from which you illuminate your environment and the surface of reflection which you call your mind, and the earth globe which you call your physical body. Now you will discover correspondences for three centers in you. One is for the I am in you. The other is for the idea in you. A third is for the vehicle which provides space for yourself to exist. This manner of understanding is called the law of correspondence. Unless we know such laws which were propounded by the ancient seers, we can never understand certain things. Even though we discover many hundreds and thousands of new sciences, mere analysis will never help you without the power to synthesize. The typewriter has all the letters in its keyboard. Similarly, we can know all the sciences in the world. But just as the typewriter cannot construct sentences of its own, a person who knows hundreds and hundreds of sciences can never make a correlation of any two sciences. No doubt the keyboard or the typewriter can give you any book typewritten in any science, any subject on this earth. But unless a person who knows the subject is there, the typewriter can never give you this book. So also, unless you know certain laws which were propounded by the ancient seers, you can never unlock certain secrets of this nature. The law of correspondences is one. Another is the law of pulsation. The law of pulsation goes like this. From consciousness, there is the descent of
power. And from the state of power, there is the descent of matter. So, in the plane of matter, we see all the planets. Again, on each planet, the atoms begin to feel the existence of themselves. As the light of the sun falls upon the atoms of each planet, every atom is a human, and it begins to feel its own I am being. That is, it gets its own awakening. On this earth, it gets its first awakening, which is called nuclear awakening. The second awakening is called the biological awakening. And the first subdivision of the biological awakening is the plant awakening. The second is the animal awakening. That is the awakening of the atom into the animal kingdom. The third awakening is human kingdom. So, from the stage of the mineral kingdom, the evolution takes place via the plant kingdom and animal kingdom into the human kingdom. But all this evolution takes place simultaneously, and it does not take one after another, just as Darwin and his followers have explained. The ancient seers differ from the idea of Darwin about evolution. The Darwinian natural philosophers believe that the higher forms evolve from the lower forms, and gradually the lower forms will disappear. Then what happens? Man has to eat man.
Man has
to eat another man. Because the plant kingdom and the animal kingdom will disappear, man has to eat man. And it is foolish to think that the evolution takes place from a step to another step. All the stages of evolution exist always. And living beings travel from one state to another. Just as we get into an aeroplane in the airport. But again, tomorrow there are passengers in the same airport. Similarly, if animal kingdom is converted into, is evolved into human kingdom today, tomorrow the plant kingdom is there to get its new recruits into animal kingdom. So, if we consider the evolution theory of the ancient seers, we will understand that the theory of Darwinians is utterly false. Now, astrology gives you a key to understand such things. How the various atoms of the planets are illumined. And on each planet, the beings are evolved into biological kingdom. Here, matter is steered by power. And again, intelligence evolves from the second stage. You will find intelligence in power, and power in the physical body. That is power in matter. Matter forms the physical body. Power forms the life. And the consciousness remains as the I am in you. The whole creation is a descent and an ascent. A descent from the subtle to the grass. From the subtle to the grass. From the you use the same term.
Yes.
Subtle to the grass. And the ascent is from the grass to the subtle. Through the same steps reverse. For example, steam is condensed into water. Water becomes ice. Again, when heated, ice becomes water. And water becomes steam. In fact, the content is neither steam nor water nor ice. So, astrology makes you understand such things properly. It makes you understand your own position. It will make your consciousness, layers of consciousness understand in the form of symbols.
Soon.
Just as chemistry is learned in the form of symbols and mathematics is learned in the form of symbols, you will learn the intelligences in yourself in the form of symbols. So instead of I am, you will call it sun. Instead of mind, you will call it moon. Instead of intellect, you will call it Mercury. Instead of love, you will call it Venus. Instead of power, you will call it Mars. Yes, instead of experience and repetition, you will understand everything in terms of certain symbols. And then these symbols exist with you just as the letters in the keyboard and the typewriter exist. Then you will be able to edit these symbols in the required manner. You will understand how to edit by knowing the movements of the planets around you. For example, if you take one solar year around you, you will find 12 new moons and 12 full moons alternating in one year. And you will come to understand that there are 12 repetitions in the year which you call months. And you will understand that there are 24 nodal points in the year.
Dans le courant de l'année.
And the ancients called it the song of the year. It's called the music of the year. It is called the meter of Gayatri by the ancient. I think you know that the Vedic meter Gayatri has 24 syllables. They have arranged it so because they wanted to give you the secrets of the 24 nodal points of the year. Then they divided the 24 into 3 equal parts. And then they could understand some more secrets. And through gradual steps, they could give us all the secrets of astrology. And they could make you understand your position. And gradually, they could give you the use of the law of correspondences. Another wonderful thing is, when you stand on this earth and look at your east, you will find a horizon. If you look at the west, you will find another horizon. Half space globe above and half space globe below. That is how it appears when you stand on this earth and look to east and west.
Lorsque nous regardons à l'est et à l'ouest.
Then they could understand the correspondence between this space globe around you and your mother's womb when you are born. You know how the egg in the mother's womb will be. A very fertilizing. The child will lie in a particular position, in the half globe position. And at the time of the fertilization of the child in the womb, if you find the planet's positions around the horizon, you will find the correspondences on the limbs of the tree. For example, if sun were to be rising at the time of the birth, the effect of sun is there on the head of the tree. So they explain certain things with this symbol. That means the head suffers from too much of more heat throughout the life of the person. And the person is never expected to go into the heat of the sun in summer. And when he goes near the equator, he will get sunstroke to the head and he may die. Similarly, if suppose Saturn were to be in the western horizon, where a child is born, there is the correspondence on the feet of the child. For example, the person is having rheumatic troubles to the legs, especially to the feet. The circulation of the blood is very sluggish, and from the beginning itself the person suffers. Like this, the astrologers could find correspondences between the sky and our body. So the east is understood as the correspondence with the stalk of the egg in the mother's womb. And the whole of the egg corresponds with the space around us from east again to east. And the brighter half of the day represents our objective consciousness, that is how we appear in the eyes of others, how others understand us. And the lower half is known as the correspondence of subjective consciousness. That is how we appear to ourselves. So, the highest mind of the upper half, which the astrologer calls the meridian, or the 10th house, it indicates the point where the person is understood by the world. For example, when the sun is there in the 10th house, everyone asks the person, is asked to hear by everyone. All people have a very big image of the person. But if there is Saturn in that other point, all persons underestimate him, though he has great potential. But it is neither an advantage nor a disadvantage to the person who knows the fact. For example, the person who has the sun in the 10th house may appear great in the eyes of others and behave in his own adamant way, and he may trouble many people in his own office, and then he may have a fall by the competition of others. Or he may preserve his own powers without using, and be honored by everyone. And this depends upon how he uses the knowledge of astrology. And the other person, when there is Saturn in the 10th house, he knows that he will be underestimated. And he knows his potentialities can never be understood by others. And for that, he may feel sorry and disappointed. And he may become retired in his life. Or he may use it to his own advantage. when others are not able to understand your own potentialities, you can use them better because they do not understand you. You can have a better hold over the other fools around you. Like this, the secret as to how to use the knowledge depends upon you, not upon the practice. So, don't think that the planets give you good or bad. If you go to the bank, are you sure the cashier will give you money if you give him a check? It depends upon your own bank account. It never depends upon the cashier in the bank. So, if you have some amount in the bank, he will be able to give you. If you have no money in the bank, even though he is your friend, he can never give you anything. Similarly, the planets discharge their duties